Hello students, this is Monika, PGT in Computer Science from CGKJ High Secondary School. Today, I am going to teach for 11th Standard Computer Applications, Chapter 10, HTML and then Structural Tags. And this video is a continuation of my previous video. In my previous video, I already explained you about HTML and what are the structural tags using in HTML and the steps to develop or to create a web page. And today I'm going to explain you about the attributes in the HTML. Before going to the topic, first you want to know what is attributes. Attributes are nothing but it's a special word that is used to specify the additional information to the tag. For example, if I'm using HTML attribute, I want to specify any other additional information like the language or additional information like alignments and all. So I have to use this attribute as a special word or a keyword inside the HTML attribute itself to give the additional information to the document. And with no more delay, we will move into the topic. The first attribute is your HTML attributes. You will have two attributes in HTML tag. One is dir and another one is lang. Dir is nothing but it's a direction of the text to be aligned. For example, if you want your web page to the text to be aligned from right to left, you have to give it as RTL. If you want the text to be aligned from left to right, you have to give it as LTR. In the attribute dir is nothing but direction. LANG is nothing but the language specified in the document. If you are writing your HTML coding in language English, you have to give it as EN. Basically default will be your English language, so no need of your representation of your language. If you are using other than any other languages, you have to mention it as like Tamil TA, Hindi HI, for Telugu you will have TE. So likewise, you have to mention the languages in your HTML tag. So these are the two attributes in your HTML tag. The first attribute will be your dir. The next attribute will be your lang. Dir stands for your direction and lang for your language. And the next tag will be your body tag. And you will have four different attributes inside your body tag. The first attribute will be your background color. In default, your HTML web page will be displayed as a white in color. If you want to change any color for your background color in the web page, you have to mention BG color, that is background color, that is equal to whatever color you want inside the body tag. For example, you can see it over here. I am mentioning as body space BG color is equal to yellow. So your web page will be displayed, that is the output will be displayed in yellow in color. The next attribute will be your image. So you the colors are not at all default. You can give the images also inside your the background of your web page. So you can first you can save your images in the desktop. Whatever images you want, you have to save in an exact location, and you have to mention that file name with the tag like body space background is equal to the file name of the image. For example, you can give flower.gif, image.gif. So if the location is in a correct path, then you can give the file name inside your body tag by using the attribute background. And the third will be your text color. Is nothing but you can give the color of your text displayed on the browser, that is output color. Like background color, you can give it as any color as you wish. And text color means the alphabets, the characters that are displayed in the browser can also be mentioned in colors. So same way, you have to give it as body tag space text is equal to color name, or you can give color code also. You will have color code for all the colors. so you can give color name or color code for background color also and for text color also. And you will have the last one is margin. Margin is nothing but if you want to display your document in the browser, say with having some margin gap, you have to mention that space in the margin. Default it will be in aligned in a no margin content, so it will not have any margin over it. If you want to display your content with the margin, you have to then display with the margin. So you have to give it as body space margin, that is top margin, and your you have to give the space over here for the top margin here, and for here you have to give the space for the right margin, and your document will be displayed in a margin wise content. And these are the four attributes in your body tag. And the next topic will be the headings. You can give headings also in the HTML document, like for example, title I gave you, like the title will be the title of the web page. It will be in the title bar. If you want to give the heading for the text, whatever you are giving in the browser page, so you have to give heading also. For example, I am giving as ABC as a heading. In my web page, what will happen? ABC will be the heading of this paragraph, and you have the content over it. And next heading I can give as next heading, and I will display the content. So the heading will be given by the tag H, open with a close tag H. And H1 to H6 is nothing but it is the size of the heading. If you want the heading to be displayed in the largest manner, you have to give it as H1, and to the smallest you will give it as H6. And for heading you will have alignment as an attribute. Alignment is nothing but you can align your heading, like you can give your heading in the center of the document, in the right of the document. Likewise, if the heading is not mentioned, alignment is not mentioned, it will consider as a left alignment as a default option. So if you align like center, the ABC will be displayed in the center of the page. If you are not displaying, if you are not giving any alignment, it will be take automatically as left as a default. And coming to the next topic, you will have paragraph and line breaks. Line breaks is nothing but you will use BR as a tag, and BR is nothing but it is a empty tag. If you open BR, there is no need of closing the BR tag again, so that is called as a empty tag. Only opening of the tag will be used. If closing is not given also, that will not create any problem over here. So if you want to give breaks in between the lines, for example, if I am displaying my name here and I am giving one break to display my qualification, so I can give after my name with a BR tag. So what will happen? The line will get break over next line at all. And the next one is paragraph. Paragraph is nothing but you can give your text in a paragraph format. For example, I can give like 4 or 5 lines together in one paragraph with alignment also. I can give right alignment, center alignment, and justify alignment. Same way, I will have here left as a default alignment. If paragraph is not mentioned with any alignment, then the HTML document itself is taken as a default alignment as your default option. And if you mention like right, center, or justify, so based on that option your paragraph will get aligned. And the last option is your comments. Comments is nothing but you can describe the content or meaning of the line with the comment line. For example, you can give with an exclamatory mark. And with all the attributes including you will have HTML attribute as direction and language, and you have four attributes in body tag, and you will have heading tag also, and that attribute of heading tag will be align, and you will have paragraph tag, line break also. So here is a small example for you. I am giving here as a direction RTL. This is nothing but the text to be aligned from right to left, and the language is EN. This is nothing but English. And head, inside the head tag you will have a title tag. The title will be displayed here as a text. So this will be displayed on the title bar of your web page. And here body tag, I already told you, you can give one or more attribute also inside the body tag by giving a space over it. BG color equal to yellow, I can give all the four also here in one single line. And H1 is nothing but, I told you, it's a heading tag. You can give from H1 to H6, from biggest to the smallest. It will be look like biggest font with a bold format. And you will have align as a center and ABC displayed in the center of your document. And here I am closing the H1 tag, and I am closing the body tag, and with the closing tag of your HTML. And I told you like about empty tag. It's nothing but it's an opening tag. It will not have any close tag. Example for that will be your break statement, line break, BR. And you have a container tag also. It's nothing but the opening and close tag will be called as the container tag. So all your tags like HTML, text, title, body, so all will comes under your container tag. It's nothing but will specify the opening tag and your close tag together. And students, today you saw like the attributes of HTML, the two attributes, and the body tag attributes with the heading tags also, and the example for a HTML document. Hope you understand what is the basic things in HTML and how to develop a basic web page with the HTML language or HTML document. And thank you, students. I'll see you in my next video.